I'm going to be building a traditional balsa wood model aeroplane kit, rubber powered. This one's from the vintage model company, made in Britain. It's a Sparrowhawk, 20-inch wingspan, your traditional sort of cabin type trainer model. Haven't made one of these for about 50 years, so should be interesting. A sheet of plans there that you build the balsa wood model on. I'll tape it down, and I've got some acetate sheet I can put over to protect the plan so you can build on top of it and release the model without it gluing itself to the paper. Drawing board, my father's old drawing board, very good for building models on. He wasn't too happy, I used to stick pins in it and cut things on it. Here's your step-by-step guide. There's also an identifier panel that tells you which parts are. So in the kit, they give you a 7-inch propeller, some wood glue, a motor hook, a 3/16 inch rubber band motor, a couple of rubber bands for holding the wings on. And then you get a piece of doweling for various pins for holding the wing on and holding the motor at the back. A bit of piano wire to build the undercarriage, then laser cut sheets for the various parts that are all detailed on the little chart beside it. Oops. So now the sheets are all laser cut, you just got to cut the tabs with a scalpel and take off the parts. It's just checking the fit of all the parts before I glue them up. Got the centre section all glued up and cut out the bits for the left hand wing. Right, I've got the centre section done, left and right hand wings. I'm waiting for them to dry, and I've got the tailplane pinned down and glued as well. Been weighing the wings down with a couple of sets of pliers just to keep them on the little 32mm blocks that I've made to get the dihedral correct. Closed pegs to clamp the ribs together as they're glued. And the central section was pinned down. There you go. That's the wing with the dihedral on each side. Right, completed tailplane. It's just a part for the fin. Still to assemble the fin. That's the tail stabiliser. Right, building the fuselage. First three formers in and the nose on. Next thing I'll to pin it to the plan and get the centre line right and glue the tail end together, get it all square and central. Just weighted that down a bit and it's sitting square to the marks in the centre line. A closed peg holding it while the glue dries. Oh, I've got all the balsa wood parts made. got the fuselage done, got the wheels done. I've got them sitting in a little, once it comes out of there, so I can slide the the undercarriage in, and slide the undercarriage in a little section in there. That's the wings. I'll go on there. Tailplane is pegged down at the moment because I'm putting the covering on. I'm just shrinking the tissue paper. Got it pegged down. Try and keep it from warping. It's just dry, the tissue paper is drying off. It's a mixture of Easy Dope, which is a water-based doping, and water, and it shrinks down. I've done the fin for it as well, just shrinking down the fuselage at the moment, and a wingtip. Got the wingtip pegged down to keep it keep the warps out of it. Hopefully the fuselage will dry straight. It's covered on all sides. It's all shrinking, hopefully at the same rate. Well, that's the rubber powered plane finished. Got the rubber motor in, undercarriage on, wings, tailplane. I've got it so the pointed balance is correct as per the plan, just fractionally behind the wing rib. Had a couple of practice glides across the living room, trying not to crash into the furniture, and it seems to glide quite nicely. You can adjust the turn by just turning the tail very, very slightly. I had to put 5 grams of blue tack in the nose to get the centre of gravity right. Total weight is 35 grams, including the motor. So just need to wait for a calm evening to have a practice flight with it. I do have a winder for winding up the rubber motor, because the motor is longer than the fuselage, so you pull it out, disconnect the rubber, connect it to the winder, and then stretch it out and wind it up, and then slowly it coils back in. When it's complete, you grab hold of the end of the rubber, let it unwind a bit, and you can hook the prop back on, and then slip the motor back in. It goes in a lot easier when there's tension on it, obviously. Oops. Goes in one way better than the other. It's also got a little digital counter on it that counts up. So every time you turn it around, it's 10 turns of the other end. So you just multiply that number by 10, and that's the number of turns you put on. It is cheap and plasticky, and the gears inside grunge a bit. Probably could do a bit of lubrication. Just plastic gears in there. But it's certainly a lot quicker than winding it by hand. Just like a bit of packing tape over the area where the rubber bands hold the wing on, just to stop it digging in. Also got a second hole in the back here so I can so I can put a peg through there and hold it in a box while you're winding the rubber motor. And once you've got the motor installed, just unplug that and off you go and fly. I'd say that was a successful first flight. Right, I've been trimming the plane a bit, tilting up the tail and putting a bit left rudder on it. A little breeze straight ahead here. See how this goes. Flying downwind, turning into the wind. Doing another loop and flying downwind. And hit a thistle. That was 650 turns. I did have a slight problem with this when I was winding it earlier. I managed to overwind it or have a nick in the rubber. It exploded and took out the side panels, both sides. You need to be careful with them when you're winding them. Make sure the winds are even. But that went very well. The wind seems to be coming from there. Yeah, not bad. Okay, it's a lot calmer now. Got 800 turns on it. The fence. Yes, very good.